Now, let us look at the second method of pricing. We talked about the cost-based method. We discussed three approaches for it. Now, let us look at the market-based transfer pricing. There are two ways or two approaches for it. The first approach is to charge what a competitive outside carrier would charge for a similar service. So that would be like charging a competitive price. This approach should consider the difference in service and rate. You need to look at that, what are the different characteristics. You cannot actually equalize yourself with some of your competitors. Remember it. They would be providing some different service. Let's say you are in the regime of LTL, less than truckload, and your competitor is in the regime of TL, truckload. They will be offering that rate and that route based on the quantity which you are shipping. Whereas in your case, if you are LTL, you might be charging a higher rate because you are taking a lower quantity to be shipped as well, and you are taking a different route as well, which is might be a customized route. So in that case, you need to take the difference into account as well, that what is the difference of the rate as well as the service from yours to your competitor. The market price may be higher or lower than the actual cost. And also remember that if you are using this approach, the other company or other transportation company might not be your competitor in a direct sense, but some indirect competitor, because TL cannot be compared with LTL companies, or minimum weight, the MW companies cannot be actually treated as a direct competitors to LTL, but they have some indirect competition. So you can take them as a reference. So your market price could be higher than that or could be lower than that. But it is on the user to actually perceive whether your service is actually higher than your competitor's service or lower than your competitor's service. The second approach is to charge an adjusted market price, that is market cost minus your cost saving. The adjusted market price may be lower if it is for the in-house transportation department is more efficient and may be higher otherwise. If your cost savings are high, then in that case, your market price for your transportation service would be lower. Otherwise, if your cost savings are low, your market price would actually be higher, your adjusted market price, because adjusted market price is actually affected by your cost savings. So if your cost savings are low, your adjusted market price would be like matching or near to the market price. But if it is higher, then you can actually take advantage of it, and your adjusted market price would be lower than your competitors' prices. Then we have transfer pricing based on a combination. This can be achieved in two ways. The first method is based on the negotiated price agreed upon between the transportation department and the users. So the user and the transportation company, they will actually negotiate the price, that what would be the transfer price, and it would be a combination. So this is one way that the user and the transportation company would negotiate and agree upon some price. That might be influenced by the market price, and it might not be influenced by the market price, because the user might have some extra requirements. The second approach is based on the target profit of the transportation department or company. Under this method, price will be equal to the actual or the standard cost plus the target profit for the department. This is like some internal mechanism in which you will be looking at the market price and you will be adding some targeted profit onto it. So this would be your actual or your standard cost plus the profit added onto it. It might become higher than the market price, or it might still be lower than the market price as well. Thank you.